Once again, you all are welcome in my channel. This is the second lecture in Artificial Intelligence series, and in this lecture we broadly cover the topics like what is AI. First of all, we took the whatsoever we studied so far, that is what is artificial intelligence, that we covered in the earlier video. If you never watched that, I advise you to just go to that video link and watch that video. And in this video we will cover the goals in artificial intelligence, what are the advantages of artificial intelligence, disadvantages of artificial intelligence, and yes, the applications of artificial intelligence. Hope you all like this video, and without wasting time, let us start this video.
So we will take a quick recap of what we did yesterday. Yesterday we completed what is the importance of AI and why should we have to learn it. There are some following points, reasons to learn about AI. Number one, with the help of AI, you can create such softwares or devices which can solve real world problems very easily and with accuracy, such as health issues, marketing, traffic issues, etc. So this we already covered. With the help of AI, you can create your personal virtual assistant like a Google Assistant, Siri, and Alexa. Right now it is very famous in the market, and you may get it within 2000 or 3000 bucks. You can easily purchase it. And with the help of AI, you can build such robots which can work in the environment where survival of human can be at risk. That is a war zone that I discussed yesterday. And AI opens a path for other technologies, new devices, and new opportunities. That is for sure. We already covered this, what is artificial intelligence is. So let me move forward. Yeah, this is a very important topic, goals of artificial intelligence, and this may be asked in the exam also. Following are the main goals of artificial intelligence. Number one, replicate human intelligence. It means whatsoever human intelligence we want, the machine can do the same task their own. So this is the one of the goal of artificial intelligence. Another goal is solve knowledge intensive task, the task which, you know, which involves knowledge, your previous knowledge. So like there are some problems where, you know, computation power is very high. Like let us suppose you have a 4-digit number lock in your briefcase. Number lock is there and you forget your password. You know how many combinations you have to search it again. That is, for one, since there are 10 words, 10 letters from 0 to 9 may become on this lock. So on another, and all fours, the 10, you know, possible numbers can become. So the total number of ways by which we can solve it is 10^4, that is 10,000. So it is very difficult for us, you know, to do it manually, to crack our password. So for that, we take an help of artificial intelligence or machine that can, you know, search it one by one, and solve it. Because manually, if you do this task, it will require a lot of time, and manually you may skip some numbers, but when it is done by artificial intelligence or by machine, it will not forget any number and it will, you know, easily crack it within a second. And similarly, an intelligent connections of perceptions and action. This is also a goal of an artificial intelligence. Yes, this is very important. Building a machine which can perform tasks that requires human intelligence, such as proving a theorem. You want to prove any theorem, like the theorems that you already learned in your previous classes, the algorithms or theorems. So to prove that algorithms, machine can help a lot, because, you know, machine can think 10,000 times faster or million times faster than the human being. So depending, since the combinations of proving a theorem are so many, so the machine can, you know, do it easily and require less time and less computation power rather than a human brain. Similarly, playing chess. Yeah, playing chess, I would like to, you know, explain here one thing. In playing chess, you know, there are different modes. I am sure you all played chess once or more on your computer or laptop. So playing chess, you know, there are three modes. One is what we called beginner, and then the moderator or last moderator, and last one is expert mode. You know, very often if we start a game with the, you know, beginner mode, then we are able to beat the computer also. But when we start a game with a expert mode, so it is very difficult to, you know, beat the computer. Why? Actually, what will happen, see, in every artificial intelligence, you know, device, how it works, it does two things. One is searching, and another one is taking action. So now, what are the possible combinations? Let us suppose, agar hamare paas koi chess game hai, if we have a chess game or any game, like I'll take an example of TikTok 2. I think you all played, that is Zero Gata. If you played Zero here, then there is a chance for another one to place cross here, and then Zero here, then cross here. Means according to your move, the next move will be decided. And this is what we call, this kind is what we call sample spaces. This is what we call search spaces. I'm writing here, this is called search spaces. Like in mathematics, I think you all know about sample spaces. Sample spaces means the possible outcomes of a particular thing. Similarly, search spaces are the possible outcomes when someone do his task. What are the various options available for you? That is what we call search spaces, right? So out of that search spaces, you pick one, because there, let us suppose in this TikTok 2 game, someone put cross here, then there are several options for you to place zero, maybe here, so many places. So these all are the, you know, possible sample search spaces. You can put anywhere. Let us suppose you put it here. Now for this cross, he has an option of these places. He can put it anywhere. So this is what we call search spaces. Now I am telling you the chess game, but how this beginner mode and moderate mode and expert mode can be set. See, search spaces means after one there are so many search spaces. This is what we call level 1 means when the next player move its, you know, jab dusra aadmi apni chaal chal leta hai, uske baad there are some another levels. Level 2, ye level 2 aa gaya hamare paas, right? Ab aise hi bahut sare levels ho jate hain, there are so many levels, right? Now agar aap, when you set the game to the level 1, so computer can only, you know, search till level 1. Aapne uski brain ko restrict kar diya, he do not, you know, machine will not move towards these levels. We can't search these levels, so it can be restricted till level 1. That's why it is a beginner, you know, beginner state. He will not, no, machine can't think beyond this level. That's why you can easily beat him. But in expert level, you set this pointer at the end, so machine, you know, have all the computation with him, with it. So it can, you know, search all the possible ways to beat you. So that's why in expert mode, you face a complex situation, or, you know, very difficult situation to beat the machine. So this how every game, whatsoever game you played, like Mario, Contra, whatsoever, Street Fighter, whatsoever game, you know, or the latest games, they all have these kind of levels, and on the basis of these levels, the beginner, moderate, and expert mode can be set. I think everybody understand this. Beginner, moderate, and expert level. Let me ask you people, if anybody have any problem, can we? Right, so I'll move forward. So this is, ek bari main aapko fir bata deta hu. Actually, there are so many competitions, you know, involved. So on the basis of the proper, you know, levels, you can set the beginners, moderate and expert mode of your game. So we will do it later on when we design some games. We will also, you know, put the levels and make it beginner and moderate and expert. We will see it later on. Now plan some surgical operation, that is also a goal of an artificial intelligence. And driving a car in a traffic, this is also one of the goal of artificial intelligence. So this is basically a building a machine which can perform tasks that requires human intelligence, such as means you want to replace the human intelligence with in these problems with the machines. And next, last goal, fifth goal, is creating some system which can exhibit intelligent behavior, learn new things by itself, demonstrate, explain, and can advise to its. That is what we call machine learning. It is also a goal of artificial intelligence. So in the exam, maybe this question will be asked to you: what are the various goals of artificial intelligence? So you have to state: number one, replicate human intelligence; number two, solve knowledge intensive task; and number three, intelligent connection, perceptions and action; building a machine; and last, creating some system which can exhibit intelligent behavior. So you just have to go through all these points. So let us move forward. Yeah, this is very important. Again, maybe 2 marks or 3 marks, this question will be asked to you: what are the various advantages of AI? What are the advantages of artificial intelligence? So number one is high accuracy with less error. This is very important. The AI machines or systems are prone to less errors and high accuracy, as it takes decision as per experience or information. So since machine will take an action with the pre-experience, and it is highly accurate and with less error. Now the next important of artificial intelligence is high speed. Definitely, since the system, the machine, can be, you know, calculate many things in a second. So depending upon the processor used, so it has AI system can be a very high speed and fast decision making. Because of that, AI system can beat chess champions in the chess game. This I told you earlier. Because AI system, it has, you know, it can think many tasks once at a time. So it is more superior than the human, we may say, but not always. We can still beat computer depending upon our skill. So highly reliable, this is very important. AI machines are highly reliable and can perform the same action multiple times with high accuracy. Yes, but for a human being, the reliability, you know, it is not always be there, because human being can be tired after some time. But machines, they are very reliable. If you want to perform many actions at a time with the machine, you can do it. Next one is useful for risky areas, already covered. That is for a war zone or where the human being have a less access, there we can use an artificial intelligence machine which can do our task easily, like defusing of bomb or exploring the ocean floor. Where to employ a human can be risky, where the human man have a less approach, there we can use an artificial intelligence machine. This is an important. And digital assistance, AI can be very useful to provide digital assistance to the user, such as AI technology is currently used by the various e-commerce site that I already covered in yesterday. I told you yesterday, in e-commerce website, to show the product as per customer requirement, the digital assistance is, you know, needed. One of my student last year, he is working on, you know, on a project that is for a real time store. He want to design some product. See what will happen whenever we do shopping through digital medium. We have, you know, access to all the things we can see, but when we go to the real store for purchasing anything, but when whatsoever we ask to the, you know, that shopkeeper, he will show that thing to us, not all. But in digital medium, you can see the whole store on your screen and you can see the, you know, all the features of that particular product that you want to buy. So one of my student in the last year, he started working to help these real-time stores. Like when a person go to the real store, how he will, you know, create something for that real store so that it will increase the chances of buying there, the product there. What I mean to say, for a shopkeeper, he want to design certain kind of app or something where the person can go and see everything in a, you know, on a screen or on his own mobile, rather than to search the whole shop. He can search the thing on his own mobile, like a real-time application he want to design for his shop. So just to increase the sale of that store. So this question is still open to you, all of you. You just suggest me some certain ways how we can help, you know, by IT, how we can help these storekeepers to promote their sale, not online, but offline. How they can promote their sale offline when a customer is inside their shop. See, what will happen, several times customer comes into the shop, but since the shopkeeper is busy somewhere else, so the customer drop the idea of purchasing the thing. So can we come up with some solution for that, so that you know, it will help the I will tell you one example. Some Reliance stores and, you know, some grocery shops, they have nowadays like a TV or like a standy they provided or with LCD. A person can, you know, search the product live there, and or they help them to, you know, to purchase the thing by showing the things, pictures, everything. So, but this is a costly thing, and the shopkeeper, they have to install it. But what I want, I want like you certain kind of help for these storekeepers. So you just go and search, or if you have an idea, we will discuss it after this lecture. So let me move forward. Useful as a public utility. This is very important. AI can be useful for public utilities such as self-driving car, which can make our journey safer and hassle-free. Facial recognition for security purpose. Natural language processing to communicate with the human in the human language. So this is also a advantage of AI. Number one, I'll repeat it again. High accuracy, high speed, high reliability, useful in risky areas. Digital assistant for e-commerce particularly, and useful as a public utility for like making more secure things, for like self-driving car, natural language processing, facial recognition we can use for a security purpose. So these are the advantages of artificial intelligence. Anybody, any problem you may ask me, or if you have a solution to the offline stores, we are open to discuss it. Yes, Shishrinadar.
Yes, sir.
Do you have any solution for or some suggestion?
So for the shops, like offline, we have one thing like Amazon did. You know that already, I think. They just walk in and they put all their stuff. The customer can put all their stuff in their bag, and they can walk out and they can pay it later on.
That is Amazon Go, but here in India, you know, there are a lot of security issues. So not only in India, but in abroad also, that is only to help them not to pay at the, you know, at the stall. You just the price get automatically deducted from your credit card. That is I think you want to mention.
Yes, sir.
But what I want, let us suppose there is an automobile shop or a mobile shop where you entered and you want to see, you know, all the products to decide which product is good for you. So how okay, I'll give this task to all of you. You just think over it, and if you have any solution, you come to me on a WhatsApp. Then we will discuss how we can, you know, this is a real problem, you know, and every shopkeeper nowadays facing it. So how you can, you know, help the retailers to increase their sale using IT. So this is a topic basically, how we can, you know, promote their sale using IT.
Sir, one thing I can mention, they can display it on a TV or a touch screen. So yeah, whatever the customer needs, they just have to select the category and they will provide you the floor and the area where these products are available.
Yeah, this is possibly one. Another like using AR and VR, like, because for a shopkeeper also, you know, it is very difficult to show all the products in a one go to all the customers. What kind of, and providing a leaflet, it shows, you know, not so good. So you just go and search it and come up with some innovative idea, like this is the idea by which we can help the retailers. So you just think it will not come in a single day. You gradually think over it, maybe you get, and then, you know, you can sell it to the many retailers, because everyone, and after the COVID, everyone, you know, get scared of. So how to make this as an opportunity for the retailers, you just think it off, then we will again discuss this topic with you. So let me move forward. Advantages of artificial intelligence is clear to all of you, and it may be asked for a marks, 3 marks or 4 marks in the exam. What are the various advantages of AI? So now let us move forward. Since every technology have an advantages, so it has a disadvantage also. So let us discuss some disadvantages of artificial intelligence here. It has following disadvantages. Number one, high cost. Yes, the hardware and the software, both are the requirement for AI. This is very important. That's why being an IT student, you contribute in, you know, software side more rather than hardware side. But I advise you all to, you know, do some hands-on on Arduino. Arduino is what and how it is helpful for you, I will explain it in the coming sections. Now Arduino is basically a hardware where it's a brain basically. It's a brain which makes this artificial intelligence, you know, enable. How, we will discuss it later on. But I think for you, if you have a knowledge of software only, you are not a complete engineer. For a completion, you must have a knowledge of hardware also. So I advise you all to go through this Arduino also. I already made one playlist on my channel for Arduino that will help you out how to, you know, connect sensors. Until or unless you are able to know how to connect the sensors with the real-time devices, so I don't think so there is any use of learning this subject. So I will tell you how to connect an Arduino with an Python and how everything can be done. Already I made several videos and it is on the YouTube channel, but definitely I will give you some hands-on on this also, how to connect hardware with the software. So but still, this is a disadvantage as compared to others equipments available or other things available in the market. Artificial intelligence devices are highly costly. That I already explained yesterday with an example of AC. If you put an you know, that 5 paisa, 10 paisa sensor with it, it will become a smart. So the overall thing is, the artificial intelligence devices are costly as it requires lot of maintenance, because sensors, they require a maintenance after a regular interval of time. If you are not doing the maintenance, then it will, you know, give you a wrong results. So everybody wants maintenance on artificial intelligence devices. So that's why its cost is very high. Another one, cannot think out of the box. This is very important. Like a human being, you know, human being can take anything, can do anything, and we can't predict. Like in this lecture, we are studying very, very, you know, calmly. But suddenly, somebody, you know, makes some noise or something. So this we can't predict. This we can't predict. Like, but I want to say, the human nature, one can't predict. But one can't predict means the human nature is a kind of heuristic nature. Whatsoever comes in someone's mind, you can't guess. Or like I want some suggestion from you people. Somebody of you will come up with, you know, very wonderful solutions of a problem. But it is not always with the artificial intelligence machine, because the machine will do only those tasks that we instructed in that machine. It will perform that thing only. It can't think out of the box, because it has the, you know, pre-programming the things. We pre-program the things, and it will think only up to that certain extent, not beyond that, like a human being. And similarly, no feelings and emotion. This is again a drawback. AI machine can't have outstanding performance. Maybe sometimes, like, you made that machine and it opposed your, you know, instructions. If it get malfunction, it opposed your, you know, function. It do not have emotions. Like you created that machine, so it will respect you. If it get malfunction, maybe it dishonors your instruction also. So this is also a disadvantage of artificial intelligence. No feelings, no emotion. Similarly, increase dependency on machine. With the increment of technology, people are getting more dependent on device, and hence they are losing their mental capabilities. Yes, this is also a disadvantage. More everyone nowadays, they all are depending upon the machines. So we forget our, you know, social responsibilities. In fact, within a family, you know, they are segregated from each other. So this is also one of the disadvantage, because increasing dependency on the machine, it is also considered is one of the disadvantages of artificial intelligence. And last, no original creativity. Yes, as human can so creative, like I want some ideas from you people. You are coming up with some, you know, novel answers. So as human can so creative and can imagine some new ideas, but still AI machine cannot beat this power of human intelligence and cannot be creative and imaginative. So artificial intelligence has these drawbacks. I will cover once again. I will read it once again. That is high cost. It is a disadvantage. Another one, can't think out of the box. No feelings, emotion. Increasing dependency on machines. And no original creativity. So these all are the disadvantages of artificial intelligence. So anybody have any question till? Yes, please raise your hand if anybody want to ask anything. Okay, let me ask then. Let me ask somebody. Okay, Yasvi Khera.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Yasvi, you understand what are the advantages and disadvantages of AI?
Yes, sir.
Can you explain what are the disadvantages?
Sir, disadvantages is it is costly, as AI is a program and they need more of sensors and all the technology, so it's a bit costly. Second, it can't think out of the box, as human can be more creative by the mind, but it's pre-programmed, so it cannot be think out of the box. Secondly, it doesn't have feeling and emotions. Same reason, because it's pre-programmed. And if we'll talk to human, if we'll request for the something, but we can't, they can understand my reason by why I'm requesting them to do such and such things. But with the AI, we can't do so. And secondly, it increased the machine dependency, that we are dependent on machine. Like we are wake up with the alarm clock. We are not wake up by or on own. So these are the disadvantages.
Very good. So what I request you all, you just go through these headings, you know, just remember these headings and write it in your own word. Don't go word with this this lecture. You just have to learn these, you know, headings and explain this. I think you all are experienced one of IP University. You can do it. You know how to make the how to, you know, explain the particular topic. So please, you just go ahead with these headings once again and try to write it in your own language rather than to copy it from here. So let us move towards the last topic. This is the last topic, that is what we call application of AI. I want to finish it today. Following are the some sectors which have an application of AI. See, these are the various sectors, very important: gaming, astronomy, healthcare, transport, agriculture, education, e-commerce, entertainment, robotics, automotive, social media, data security. So you can see no sector, you know, left. All the sectors are comes under AI. So now you can understand how important this subject is. If you have an interest in healthcare, then also learning this subject AI is useful for you. See, no sector is left behind. Finance, education, e-commerce, entertainment. Now, what I want, after this lecture, you should be come up with your, you know, own interest. Maybe some people have an interest in robotics. Some are very good in digital marketing or social media. Some are good in data security. I told you, now I am right now working in this area. Data security means I am working on a real project, that is cryptography using AI. So I am working on this area. So but earlier I worked here, earlier I worked in this area also. I designed, you know, I advise you all to just go through internet and put my name, Dr. Pawan Wing, and put types of media or COVID-19. You will come across one topic. I designed one, our latest device, you know. The device is basically what it do. It will not only tell you, you know, the social distance, like 6 feet. It will not only tell you the 6 feet of a person, that a person is 6 feet away from you. It will tell you also whether that person have a COVID symptoms or not. See, measuring a distance is not a bigger task. Measuring, you can measure a distance by an ultrasonic sensor. You put an ultrasonic sensor, it will measure the distance. But in my device, I designed one device that not only measure the distance, but also it tells you the symptoms, like you know, a COVID person have a high fever. This is the most one of the
thermal thermal scanning,
but you know, this device you can put it on your belt, like a human being. You can put it around your belt. You have to fix it at your back, and if a person comes within 6 feet behind you, then it will give an alert to you on your mobile that somebody it has no use now. If anybody who have not COVID symptoms is standing behind you, so you need not to be bothered about that. But if somebody who is really, you know, suffering from the COVID and standing behind you within the 6 feet range, it is dangerous for you. So I'll advise you to just go and read that article, or I will share it in the group. You just go. It is published in Times of India also, Indian Express also. Recently we designed this device, and we are very soon we marketed in the, you know, in the market. So my whole idea to tell this thing to you is that I worked in this health sector area also. Earlier my students worked in this transport sector. How few of my students, they are also from MCA. They come to me 2 years back. They said, we want to, you know, design one kind of sort of app where, you know, there is an intimation of DTC bus. Like वो लड़की बच्चे थे, वो कहते थे, सर हम DTC बस के स्टैंड पे जाके वेट करते हैं और उस टाइम पे कुछ भी मिसहैपनिंग हो सकती है. तो हम चाहते हैं कुछ ऐसी एक ऐप बना दें जिसमें हमें पता लग जाए कि बस जो है 10 मिनट में आने वाली है और मैं 10 मिनट पहले ही खाली वहाँ पर जाऊँ, उस प्लेटफॉर्म पर जाऊँ. सो मैंने कहा ये तो बहुत अच्छा है. इसके लिए हमें गूगल असिस्टेंस चाहिए था, गूगल का मैप चाहिए था, बट द थिंग इज उस बस के अंदर जो ड्राइवर है या कंडक्टर है या वो जो बस है उसके अंदर वो GPS सिस्टम होना चाहिए। अब दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट जो है वो GPS सिस्टम हर बस में लगाना नहीं चाह रही थी, तो हमने उनको एक आइडिया दिया, कोई बात नहीं, हर बस के अंदर आप क्या करो, आप जो स्मार्टफोन होते ही हैं सबके पास, कंडक्टर के पास या उसके पास, तो आप उसको कहो कि अपना कंडक्टर को कहो कि अपना गूगल मैप ऑन कर ले, सो डैट वो सारी कनेक्टिविटी बन जाए और गूगल के थ्रू वो वहाँ पे डिस्प्ले हो जाए। सो फॉर डैट आवर स्टूडेंट मेट यू नो GM ऑफ DTC, ही ऑल्सो दे हैव अ कॉस्ट कंस्ट्रेंट, बेसिकली वो पैसा नहीं खर्चना चाहते थे, बट वट आई वॉन्ट टू टेल यू देर आर लॉट ऑफ स्कोप यू नो इन एवरी एरिया। मेरा ओनली पॉइंट आपसे ये डिस्कशन का यही है कि आपके पास यू नो आज की डेट में आप आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस को किसी भी एरिया के साथ कनेक्ट कर सकते हो, तो अब वो आपकी स्ट्रेंथ आपको देखनी है कि आपको क्या आता है, क्योंकि मेरे को इंडिविजुअली एक एक के बारे में नहीं पता कि आपका क्या इंटरेस्ट एरिया है, बट यू कैन फाइंड योर इंटरेस्ट एरिया जरूर इस सर्कल के अंदर होगा। तो आप अपने एरिया के साथ AI को कैसे कनेक्ट कर सकते हो, वो आपके लिए सबसे बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट टास्क होगा, वो वही आपकी अचीवमेंट होगी इस सब्जेक्ट की। क्योंकि जब आप मार्केट में जाओगे, जो आपका इंटरेस्ट एरिया है उसके बारे में आपको बहुत नॉलेज है, जो भी आपका इंटरेस्ट एरिया है, लाइक अभी मेरे निश्चल से बात हो रही थी, वो कह रहा था डाटा साइंस में मैंने काम किया हुआ है, तो डाटा साइंस उसका एक एरिया है, एक इंटरेस्ट एरिया है, तो उसके बारे में उससे जितनी मर्जी बहस कर लो उसको सब आता है। अगर अब इसके साथ उस इंटरेस्ट एरिया के साथ वो एक प्रोजेक्ट बना ले, एक ऐसा प्रोजेक्ट बना ले जो कि उसके इंटरेस्ट एरिया को कवर कर रहा है, तो वो मार्केट में जब भी कभी उसका इंटरव्यू होगा, कोई भी कंपनी आपके पास आएगी या आप किसी पे ऑफशोर कंपनी पे जाओगे, तो आप उसको अच्छे से समझा सकते हो कि आपका प्रोजेक्ट क्या है, आपका इंटरेस्ट आपको कैसे काम कर रहा है, क्योंकि वो आपका इंटरेस्ट एरिया है। सो जस्ट गो विथ योर इंटरेस्ट एरिया, यू कम अप विद द आइडियाज। सी आई एम ओपन टू ऑल ऑफ यू, एनी टाइम यू कैन कंसल्ट मी ऑन यू नो व्हाट्सएप, आई विल डेफिनेटली हेल्प यू आउट टू फ्रेमिंग योर टॉपिक। समटाइम्स व्हाट विल हैपन ना, हमारे पास टॉपिक होता है लेकिन हमें पता नहीं है कि उसको स्टार्ट कैसे करना, सो यू जस्ट कम टू मी, आई विल टेल यू हाउ टू यू नो वर्क स्टार्ट वर्क, और अनटिल और अनलेस यू हैव समथिंग यू नो हैंड्स ऑन इन योर हैंड, बेटा जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटी बड़ी मुश्किल है फिर मार्केट के अंदर, वो फिर उल्टी सीधी जॉब्स मिलेंगी, आपको कोई फ़ायदा नहीं। बट आई वॉन्ट, अगर आप अपने टेस्ट की जॉब चाहते हो तो आप उसके अंदर कुछ ऐसा प्रोडक्ट सा बनाओ, कुछ एटलीस्ट प्रोडक्ट नहीं भी बना रहे तो आइडिया तो हो आपके पास, कोई ऐसा आइडिया जो कि अभी मार्केट के अंदर एग्जिस्टिंग नहीं है, एंड यू कैन थिंक आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स। यू जस्ट, जैसे इस लड़की ने सोचा था कि भाई मैं सिक्योरिटी, ये बेसिकली उसने वुमेन सिक्योरिटी, वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट के ऊपर, और गवर्नमेंट फंड करती है, गवर्नमेंट इज़ रेडी टू फंडिंग यू इफ़ यू हैव एन आइडियाज और यू हैव अ टाइम यू कैन और यू हैव अ स्किल, तो आपको ऑटोमेटिकली गवर्नमेंट फंड करती है, पैसों की आप चिंता मत करो। द थिंग इज यू शुड हैव टू कम अप विद सम नोवल आइडियाज लाइक सो आई विल ऑल्सो कवर दिस टॉपिक विद इन 5 मिनट्स, यू जस्ट गिव मी 5 मिनट्स। AI in astronomy, how artificial intelligence can be useful to solve complex universe problem. You know, in universe there are several problems which are right now it is not answerable, but with the help of the AI we can have a solution for that. Similarly, AI in healthcare, in the last 5 to 10 years AI become more advantageous for the healthcare industry and going to have a significant impact on his industry. हेल्थ इंडस्ट्री आर अप्लाइंग AI टू मेक मैटर एंड आई थिंक एवरीबडी नोज दिस, डायग्नोस्टिक के अंदर हेल्प कर रहा है AI लास्ट। अब हमारे पास ऐसे ऐसे इक्विपमेंट हैं, वी कैन ईजिली यू नो मेडिकल चेकअप कर सकते हैं, टेस्ट जो है बड़े ईजिली कर सकते हैं, सो दिस इज ऑल ड्यू टू द AI. AI इन गेमिंग में कैसे कर सकते हैं, द AI मशीन्स कैन प्ले स्ट्रेटेजिक गेमिंग्स लाइक चेस, वेयर द मशीन नीड टू यू नो हैव अ लार्ज पॉसिबल स्पेसिस, जिसके अंदर उसके बहुत सारे प्लेसेज होते हैं सर्च करने के, तो AI गेमिंग is also AI in gaming you can use if you are good in designing gaming, aapne koi game banayi hai, so now try to implement AI with that game, like maine dekha hai kai bacche C++ mein bhi game bana dete hain, like TikTok 2, I will share the code with you all, python code I have of TikTok 2 game, so in TikTok 2 game aap game hamare paas hai, now what your aim is, what you have to do is with your skill you have to put you know low medium high. So for that you have to apply certain levels in this is algo ke andar usko aapko kuch levels ko set karna hai, so I will tell you how I will cover this thing also. AI in finance, right, sorry, AI in finance, AI and finance industries are best matches for each other. Finance industry implementing automation, chatbots, adaptive intelligence, algorithm trading, yes, trading algorithm. जैसे आपने देखा होगा जो बच्चे ट्रेडिंग करते हैं या जो कोई लोग ट्रेडिंग करते हैं, ट्रेडिंग मतलब जो सेंसेक्स में मार्केट के अंदर पैसा वैसा लगाते हैं. यस, सो वहाँ पे AI यूज़ होता है. वहाँ पे भी आजकल डेट में AI यूज़ हो रहा है. यू कैन यू नो प्रिडिक्ट विच स्टॉक यू नो गिव यू एडवांटेज और विच स्टॉक विल गो मूव अपवर्ड एंड डाउनवर्ड्स. विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस AI यू कैन प्रिडिक्ट इट बट नॉट फॉर श्योर. But with much better accuracy, you can predict it. AI in data security, yes. In data security, there are so many algorithms for key generation and cyber attacks. So for that, AI can you know make it more secure by more you know complex calculations like your password. You know, you received password on a carbon paper. That password is generated through pseudo number generator. I think everybody knows what is pseudo number generator. It is random number generator. So that random number generator that password is not known by anybody. It is just given to you, and that since it is machine generated, that's why it is advisable to you to just change it because it is little bit complex. So but otherwise or it is very secured. And nobody knows that password. But why they said you to change it? Just because it is little bit complex. So you change it and according to your convenience, you have to change it. So this is also a application of AI in the data security. Similarly, AI in social media sites such as Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat contains billion of users' profile, which need to be stored and managed in a very efficient way. Yes, for that, we can use AI to manage a massive amount of data. So AI can analyze lot of data to identify the latest trends, hashtags. This is all the crawling of you know Google, how Google crawl and how Google also they made their own algorithm, changes their algorithms day by day. Same similarly Facebook. So that you know the people as the algorithm get changed, and if you know the algorithm, you can play it with. But that's why they you know regularly change their algorithms. This is a very difficult task for digital marketing engineers. That's why as soon as they came to know about the algorithm get changed. So they have to be keep on updating theirself, how the algorithm is performing, how the things how these things get done. So they have to be keep themselves updating. It is not an easy task. So next is AI in travel and transport. Yes, in travel and transport, AI is capable of doing various travel related works such as making travel arrangement. Yes, like your flight booking, your best routes. It will tell you, let us suppose you plan to visit abroad. So AI in travel and you just booked your ticket, and you know you immediately you will get the information about the best hotels, and they came to know that you are visiting on that date, and they will send you know messages and everything. This is all done with the help of AI in travel and transport. So to make your you know life convenient and better, and to get a fast response. Similarly, AI in automotive industry, this is very important. Some automotive industries are using AI to provide virtual assistant to their users for the better performance. Yes, such as Tesla has introduced Tesla bot. It is just like a virtual assistant, like your Siri or like the Siri or virtual assistant. Various industries are currently working. Yeah, this is the area where this is a gap where you can work. Various industries are currently working for developing self-driven car, which can make your journey more safe and more secure. But I tell you now, as soon as till the time we have this sensor technology cheaper and more accurate, we are not able to get this self-driven car. But as soon as we have this technology with us, the sensor technology and another one, the cost of this sensor technology, we soon have this self-driven car, which is more you know safe. Next one is AI in robotics. Artificial intelligence has a remarkable role in robotics. I think everybody knows we are creating several robots So AI in robotics has its own advantage. Humanoid robots are those robots which are act like a human being, are the best example for AI. Like Sophia, you heard about it, that can talk and behave like an human. So we are more, but still it is not perfect. We are, you know, continuously working in this area to create a humanoid robot which can exactly like a human, think like a human and perform like a human. We have very much accurate robots nowadays, but still we are working in the field of, you know, making them more accurate. Last, AI in entertainment. We are currently using some AI based application in our life with some entertainment device like Netflix. You know, Netflix, I think everybody used it, Netflix or Amazon. With the help of ML and AI algorithm, these services shows the recommendation for the program or shows. Next, in AI in agriculture. In agriculture sector, the robotics, solid crop monitoring, crop prediction, like let us suppose the in the field the water or humidity level get low down, so motors get automatically, you know, on. This is how we can implement AI in an agriculture. Similarly, AI in commerce, I already covered this. In commerce industry, they keep on tapping you. Once you go and Google something, they keep on tapping you to, you know, and make you convince you to buy that product. And last, AI in education. AI can automate grading. Yes, you just have to give your exam. The result will automatically come. It will check by the, you know, virtual tutor for the student. So this is how AI can be used in education. So this is all about the today's lecture. We cover the three things. Number one is advantages, then disadvantages, and then applications. So these are the three topics. And you just write one question. What are the applications?